Let's talk about your dream. Where did your dream begin? Where was it launched?
You know what? I don't ever remember not having a dream. That's kind of like how far back it goes. Now, ultimately, I've had success being a filmmaker, and that started when I was at FAMU, Florida A&M University.
And for the people that aren't familiar with you or your work, can you just run down some of your past projects?
Yeah, of course. The first project that we had that kind of really hit was Stomp the Yard. And, you know, it was a movie that nobody in Hollywood saw coming. I pitched to every studio in Hollywood, and they all told me no twice. And it was on the third time that I went back to Sony Pictures that I got them to agree to make that film. And it opened number one at the box office. And the funny thing about opening number one is that all of a sudden you can get your calls returned. So that was a blessing for us. It opened number one and stayed number one for 2 weeks. And after that, we made a film called This Christmas, which opened really well. And then I made a film called Obsessed with Beyonce, which opened number one. Last year, I had a film called Takers that opened, and that opened at number one. So I have been very successful. And my latest project is called Think Like a Man, and that's in theaters this spring. So I'm excited about that.
Who inspired you? Who did you look up to?
I would be remiss if I didn't talk about people like Oscar Michaud, people like Spike Lee, the Hudlin brothers. My first ever movie internship was with Warrington and Reginald Hudlin. And I was coming out of college and I got a chance to intern on a film project and I was in the camera department and my job was to wrangle the cable. I just had to make sure that when the director of photography was filming that the cable connected to the camera, which led to the monitors, never got tangled. That was my job. When I tell you I was the best cable wrangler, camera PA in the history of movies, I was on it, brother. I was serious about it because I had that whole you have to be great with whatever you do. So the Hudlin brothers gave me an opportunity to kind of see the inner workings of a real film up close and personal. But the strides that people like Spike, people like John Singleton, and certainly when you go historical, the legacy of people like Oscar Michaud allowed me as an African-American filmmaker to have the level of success that I've had.
Those 4 or 5 years when things weren't as successful as you wanted them to be, what sustained you? What got you through day to day when things weren't working out?
Faith, absolutely, no question. One word, faith. I was a freshman and hooked up with my now lifelong business partner, Rob Hardy. He wanted to be the next Spike Lee. That was his thing. I want to be a director, I want to make movies. I wanted to be an entrepreneur. I didn't know what I wanted to be, AJ. I just knew that I wanted to work for myself. I helped him to make an independent movie on the campus of FAMU. It was called Chocolate City, and it came out. We shot it for like 20 grand. At the end of the day, by the time we had hustled, taken prints around and sold t-shirts, hats, and soundtracks, and showed it in our little Tallahassee community and put it on DVD, the movie had made $100,000. That was all the money in the world for two broke college students. So I said, you know what? This is my business right here. This is my entrepreneurial endeavor. We made the movie, sent to Hollywood, nobody cared. So there was a journey to getting that money because we sent it to Hollywood, nobody cared. We did the world premiere of Chocolate City at Tallahassee, invited everybody. I mean, literally, Spielberg, Lucas, Paramount, Sony. My mama was like, you know, you gotta invite Oprah, baby. We invited Oprah. Of course, nobody came, but I will never forget standing on the stage at that premiere with an empty front row, because we had saved seats for all these people just in case they decided to show up. None of them came, but it forced us to distribute the film ourselves. And that's ultimately how we became successful.
Now, what would you say to the young man or young woman that has the dream to do what you want to do? How would you help them, or what advice would you give to them to fulfill their dream?
I would tell them that it is your dream. If it is really your dream and your passion, I don't care if it's that you want to be a movie producer, an actor, a director, or you want to be a physicist, an astronaut, or the president of the United States, keep living your dreams. You have to control your own destiny. Too often, they are too quick to say, well, this person of some importance said that I wasn't good enough or I don't have what it takes, so, you know, I gotta give up, I gotta do something else. No, you define your own level of success.
What do you want your legacy to be?
It'd be twofold. As a filmmaker, I'm somebody that is still searching for that sweet spot of commercial success and viability and critical acclaim, you know? I'd love to make that film that works in, you know, Hollywood, economic imperative sort of way, but also it's something that people say, you know what, it touched me. It was, you know, it was successful on a few levels. So I'd love to be somebody that's remembered for, you know, quality projects that people enjoyed. But the bigger thing, I guess, if I had to speak to my own legacy, would just be, you know, that I was somebody who hopefully had an effect on a community, you know? And be that the African American community, be that the human community, just somebody that, for me, a filmmaker is what I do, it's not what I am. What I am is I'm a father, you know? And I take that very, very seriously. And certainly with my own kids, but also I do a lot of engaging and touching and talking to kids elsewhere. So if there's anything that I'd love to be left, it's that he's somebody that, you know, made a difference. I think that's the thing. When you leave this earth, you know, it's like, what did you do? Make an impact some kind of way. I'd love to be remembered as somebody that made some difference, some way, somewhere with somebody.
Perfect.
Well, you're making a difference.
Thank you, brother. I appreciate it.